Hi everyone, I'm Sonia from ACROBOTIC Industries, and today we're going to learn about how to get started with the Raspberry Pi. In this tutorial, we'll be going over a brief introduction of the Raspberry Pi, downloading the operating system Raspbian onto a microSD card, connecting some peripherals to the Raspberry Pi, and some configuration settings during your first boot up. I'm using the latest model of Raspberry Pi, which is Raspberry Pi 3 Model B. For power, I have a 5.1 volt 2 amp power adapter that delivers enough power to the Raspberry Pi for it to operate without any problems. I also have an 8 gigabyte microSD card, and you're welcome to use any size you'd like so long as it's over 4 gigabytes. Some additional items I'll use are a USB wireless keyboard and mouse, a video monitor with HDMI input, and my laptop, which doesn't have a built-in card reader, so I'll be using a USB adapter to access the SD card. Before jumping in, I want to tell you a little bit about the Raspberry Pi. The Raspberry Pi is a small computer that you would use as you would any other computer. You can view and edit text documents, you can browse the internet, check your email, fill out spreadsheets, and even play games. As an added bonus, you can very easily interact with electronic hardware such as sensors, LEDs, motors, and we'll go over how to do that in future videos. The Raspberry Pi was invented back in 2006 in the University of Cambridge in England, where a group of people got together to develop a small-sized, affordable computer for children. Their motivation was the declining number of student applicants to computer science programs. After about 6 years of development, they put it out on the market with a target price of $35. Since then, the Raspberry Pi has had a meteoric rise to success. And earlier this year, they reported over 8 million Pis sold. That's a lot of Pis. So for getting started with your Raspberry Pi, the first thing we need to do is download the operating system. Just like any computer running Windows or Mac OS X, the Raspberry Pi needs an operating system running on it. So follow along with me as I go to the Raspberry Pi website, which is raspberrypi.org. Go to the download section, and there you'll see different options for operating systems. In this tutorial, we'll be using Raspbian, so go ahead and select Raspbian. Then click on download zip. After a few minutes, you should have this file downloaded onto your computer, and this is the file that we will need to write onto the microSD card. Simply dragging and dropping isn't going to work, so I'm going to show you the preferred way of doing this on Mac OS X. For Windows users, check out our other video on how to do this. On Mac OS X, we're going to be using the Terminal app, which can easily be found by running a Spotlight search. Your window might not look like mine, and that's because I have mine configured through the preferences to be using a particular theme. Before connecting your microSD card, we're going to issue the list show command and this particular path. This shows all the physical devices and partitions that are currently present in the system. Now you can connect the SD card either directly to the computer or using a USB adapter, as in my case. Once that's done, reissue the list show command by pressing the up arrow and hitting enter. You will see the same list as before, but with some additional entries. These new entries represent what has been designated for the SD card on the system. Now that we have this information, we're going to issue the disk utility command to unmount the microSD card. Hitting enter should give you an unmount successful message. Next, we have to unzip the file that we downloaded from the Raspberry Pi website. Double-click to unzip the file. I've already done this, so I'm going to hit cancel. Once your file has been unzipped, go back to terminal and use a DD utility by typing this command. To use a DD utility, we need to specify a couple of things. The first is a location of the unzipped file that's to be written onto the microSD card, and the second is the actual location of the microSD card, which we got earlier by using the list show command. After you hit enter, you'll have to wait about 10 minutes for the process to complete, but when you see a message like you see here on the screen, you're ready to move on. Now that you're ready to insert your microSD card, take the Raspberry Pi and turn it upside down and insert the card into the slot, making sure that it's secured. Connect your peripherals such as your keyboard and your mouse. Mine are wireless and both connect to this one USB dongle. Take your HDMI cord for your video monitor and connect it to the HDMI slot. And make sure that your video monitor is powered on, otherwise the Raspberry Pi might not register that it's connected. And finally, take your micro USB cable and connect it for power to the Pi. Your Raspberry Pi should take a few seconds to boot up. While it does that, you'll see a loading screen. Once your Raspberry Pi has fully booted, you'll be loaded into a desktop environment. Since it's our first time booting up, there are some options that we'll need to configure to make your life easier. In the upper left-hand corner from the Raspberry Pi menu, we're going to open up the terminal app that lives on the Raspbian operating system. From the terminal, we will run raspi config. This will take us to a configuration window where we'll set up some preferences. We'll start with expanding the file system. Hit enter to access the entire space available on your SD card. Next, we move on to adjusting the system time, which will be under internationalization. This is menu option 5. Scroll down to option 2 to select change time zone. Since we're located in the US, that's what I'll select. Hitting enter to make your selection. Now we'll select our time zone. I'm not exactly sure if Pacific Ocean or Pacific New is exactly the one we want, but I'll select Pacific New. The next setting we'll want to change is our keyboard layout, which is also located under internationalization. This time we'll go down to option 3, hitting enter to select. I'm going to select the default, which is 105 key. And the default setting is English UK because these boards are manufactured in the UK. I'm going to select other and scroll down to English US. Scroll all the way to the top and hit enter. Hit enter again and enter again for no compose key. Hit enter again for no. And now we'll hit tab twice to select finish. Hit enter and select yes for reboot now. And your Raspberry Pi should restart with the new settings already configured. Once the system restarts, we'll be loaded once again into the desktop environment where you'll be able to select any of the many programs that come pre-installed on the Raspberry Pi. These are available from the menu in the upper left-hand corner. In the upper right-hand corner, click to select your Wi-Fi network to get you ready to browse the internet. Now that your Raspberry Pi is up and running, you're ready to take on new challenges. Subscribe and watch our other videos to help you along the way. Thank you for watching. I'm Sonia from ACROBOTIC Industries. See you guys next time.